Hello, I'm Isaac Yamahata. In this session, I'd like to discuss about guest memory protection and how we can proceed for its detection. At first, I'd like to discuss about what guest memory protection is, and then to leverage that. And then I'd like to discuss about KVM hypervisor side, and then discuss about QEMU user space side. At first, I'd like to introduce what guest memory protection is. These days, cloud computing is widely accepted. It means your workloads runs on the environment that someone else is managing, and also in the same machine, other someone else's workload can run. So we cannot always trust the execution environment. And for several reasons, it can be accidental or it can be intentional by malicious people. So that your data can be stored or looked into it. And so it's not desirable. So there are requirements to protect your VM or eventually your data or processed result from even hypervisor or host OS or even firmware. There are several technologies available in the market. And in QEMU or KVM world, the terminology guest memory protection is to be used to be vendor neutral. At first here, let's discuss about KVM hypervisor side. Currently, when guest touches its guest memory, KVM MME fault happens and the KVM hypervisor notified so that KVM MME converts guest physical address into host physical address. And then KVM MME updates its KVM MME page tables, which is different from usual CPU page tables. And currently, the current implementation assumes that guest memory region is mapped into user space, mostly in our case, GMU, and it uses get user pages or its variant to convert from guest memory address, guest physical address to host physical address. But for memory protected guest, actual guest memories is not necessarily mappable to user space. So KVM MME needs to be enhanced to not use user space mapping. And also for kernel identity mapping is also an issue, but it's another story. So in this session, I don't discuss this about kernel identity mapping. Okay, so in order to enhance KVM MMU, let's analyze what operation is needed and essentially what new interface is needed to support what kind of operations. Basically, KVM MMU needs to the following three operations. The most basic one is the address conversion from guest physical address to host physical address. When guest touches guest physical memory, KVM MMU is notified and KVM MMU resolves guest physical address into host physical address to back guest memory. And then KVM MMU updates host physical address into KVM MMU page tables. And then guest can, after that, a guest can continue its execution. The remaining two operations are for live migration. One is to log the page. And the last one is use the fault FD for post copy live migration, which propagates KVM MME fault into QM. Let's discuss about one by one. At first, we'd like to allow multiple backends for MME operations. Actually, there can be multiple backends as there are multiple technologies for guest memory protection. And also there are several memory technologies to back guest VM in addition to normal DRAM backed memory. There are DAX technology to back memory. And also, there are several ways to back guest memories. So, we'd like to introduce. So far, actually in Linux or Unix world, abstraction is a file descriptor and user space mapping. So far, the current implementation is good design to use get user pages, but for guest memory protection, it's not assumed that the protected memory is not mappable into user space or kernel address space. So the current existing abstraction for KVM MMU is not good enough. So we'd like to introduce new abstraction or one more layer so that we can abstract, we can introduce new backend. For example, and the existing implementation can be converted into the under those new interface or new abstraction. And in theory, we can introduce, for example, DAX memory or DAX FS, or if we can simply use anonymous file or anonymous inode. In that case, address conversion can be X array over address space. And for guest memory protection, other backend should be able to be implemented. For dirty page logging, currently, it traverses CPU page tables and also allow KVM, VMM, or other PV devices can mark page dirty, and it will be recorded in page tables. But instead of marking PT dirty, it should be also able to record it or handle it in its backend. And next is to support post copy. Now this is very interesting. To support for post copy, guest MMU, KVM MMU fault is actually converted into normal user page fault. And then the fault is propagated into user space via user fault FD. And the user fault FD is very tightly integrated into Linux CPU MMU implementation. So if we implement other KVM MMU backend, that won't use user space mapping. User fault FD won't be directly adapted. So probably we'd like to introduce a new fault FD, like something like KVM fault FD. And then it will be plumbed into KVM MMU backend. probably yeah, the backend interface to QEMU will be mostly same to user for TFD. So that QEMU doesn't require much modification. Yeah, another thing to consideration in KVM VMM side, yeah, it's to allow multiple type of VM. Typically cloud operators, cloud admin will expect to allow both guest memory protected VM and no normal VM to coexist. So under typically protected VM can have a different capability from normal VM. So KVM capability IO controllers needs to be per VM, not device KVM device wise, because such capability is not system wide. And also, same changes needed for QEM to use VM IO controller instead of KVM device IO controller. And typically, such protected VM requires has a different capability from normal VM. Some functionalities and usable or doesn't make sense, or some features must be enabled for protected guest. So we'd like to introduce MAFUX to disable or forcibly enable those features. And also, some features is different from normal one. So we'd like to add more hooks for CPUs or CPU ID, or MSR or memory to be initialized. What toned down. So some of such twisting can be realized by normal QEMU configuration variables, and such devices enabled or disabled, ACPI tables also needs to be twisted according to actual device enablement or disablement. For now, protected VM to work, actually only not reporting disabled device suffice, but for to reduce attack surface, we'd like to also really disable them in device emulation. Those also, we can go further. For example, chipset is only initialized at BIOS startup and want to be changed after that. For example, MM config region, the region to access PCI Express config space will be only initialized on startup and then won't be touched. And actually, such initialization will increase guest BIOS size, and also it may have a subtle implication. So actually, we'd like to reduce such attack surface. So we'd like to twist reset device reset state, so that guest BIOS doesn't need to initialize it, and devices are ready to use without any initialization. And if we do so, some device registers doesn't make sense. So and we'd like to disable or we'd like to prohibit access to those IO, port IO, or MMIO, so that device state, some of that device state can be freeze. And the implementation should be sort of frameworked. We don't like to get if class, if this technology enabled, enable this device or disable device, and so on. So yeah, it should be uniform implementation. So yeah, I'd like to propose some issues to make progress in this effort. One is add more hooks for CPU or memory initialization or teardown. And also alongside with that, we need more knobs for CPU IDs or MSR. And also, we'd like to add more knobs to disable device or device itself or device register, subset of device registers, if appropriate. And also, we'd like to add after reset hook to twist reset status, so that device is in a state so that guest VM can ready to use. And also, I'd like to add allowed list of IO, port IO or MMIO region, which configured on startup, so that device can be freezed or can we directly prohibit from further device modification. So that guess to reduce guest attack surface. Okay, thank you for listening. I can take questions after this session.